This new moon in Taurus is a super exciting, positive new beginning, and it is my favorite new moon of the entire year. I highly recommend that you use this energy to start something that you're really excited about and passionate about building. And if not, just like have a good day, because it's a really, really good alignment. So if you're excited to dive into what the astrology has to say about this new moon in Taurus in general and for you specifically based on your sign, make sure that you like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you are always up to date with what the stars have in store for you. Hi, I'm Erin. I'm an astrologer and I also make music. So if you want to listen to my music, get an astrology reading, or look at any of my other content, all that is down below. So we're going to start out by talking about the overall energy of this new moon and what the alignment means. And then we will get into what to expect based on your specific sign. So do wait till the end to hear that. So this new moon is happening on May 7th, 2024 at 8:23 p.m. Pacific time. So it's happening at a little after 11 Eastern time on the night of the 8th. New moons are always when the sun and the moon are together in the sky. And this one has the sun and the moon together at 18 degrees of Taurus. So with the sun and the moon in Taurus, Taurus energy is highlighted. That is stable, dependable earth sign energy. It is about firm foundations, loyalty, and dependability. The moon is also exalted in Taurus. The moon loves being in Taurus. The moon is the emotional tides and the changing of feelings and the way that we are interpreting things on a more daily basis. And the moon loves being in Taurus because Taurus is stable and dependable and means that the person or just the collective energy at hand is more able to navigate things without going all over the place. Since this is happening at 18 degrees, it is happening in the second decan of Taurus, which is actually associated with the Six of Pentacles tarot card. And it's called the Lord of Success because this card and this part of the sky is pretty associated with both emotionally and physically out in the world, feeling successful and put together. Like there's a good balance of being fulfilled as well as working hard. And it shows that you've come a long way and you're doing something that is rewarding and you're able to feel celebratory about that. It is also an indication of a really stable amount of success. You're slowly and steadily becoming proud of what you've done, and it's nothing that feels like it's all over the place or an overnight success either. So even with just these things, this is an awesome new moon. It has so much fertile, grounded, stable energy, and it is an indicator of what you're building having success. Now, this new moon gets even better, and the major reason that this makes this new moon so interesting is that not only are the sun and the moon in Taurus, but Venus, Jupiter, and Uranus are all there as well. So Venus is at home in Taurus. Venus rules Taurus, and Venus describes luxury, having harmony, being socially put together with others, and having a good time. It can also show romance or just a lot of love involved. Jupiter is the planet of abundance and growth and positivity and overarching success and optimism. And Uranus is a planet of disruption, chaos, innovation, and insight in a really new, novel, unconventional way. So Venus and Jupiter together for this shows both interpersonal success, romantic success, and harmony, and also just overall optimism and experiences that are super beautiful and glowing and really expanding our horizons. And all that together is really positive. And then Uranus adds a little bit of this like fire or a little bit of this lightning burst of it being a little bit different than usual and possibly sudden, not exactly what we expected or unconventional in a sense. So this is both a very positive new moon, a very great new beginning for getting along with others, romance, creativity. This is an incredible energy and also has a little bit of a kick to it where it's not going to happen exactly as normally you'd expect it to be and is a little bit more interesting than usual, which personally I really like and think is interesting. And Uranus, when it's with Venus and Jupiter, is not really an unwanted energy. However, it can be a little bit of a crazy energy, so that is something to be aware of. And there is also a sextile to Saturn and Pisces very closely. So sextiles are not that big of a deal, I will admit. Sextiles are the light positive aspect. They represent the potential of opportunity. With this new moon sextiling Saturn, which is the planet of stability and seriousness, it shows that with all of these opportunities and growth and expansion, there is also the opportunity to stay grounded and rooted. And with this new moon being in Taurus, I'm not too worried about this being a flighty or delusional new moon. This just appears to be the beginning of something that is a huge, intentional, and rewarding experience that is a big win and slowly and steadily becomes something beautiful. So I would highly recommend using this energy. And truthfully, there's really not even a downside of things going on. It's pretty clear and stable, and not really stable, actually. It's conjunct Uranus, but it is a very straightforward energy. So if you already have any plans or anything that you want to do under this new moon, let me know in the comments below how you are going to be spending this day. So now we're going to get into what this means for you based on your rising sign. So Aries risings, this is in your second house of money and income. You seem to be making a new income stream or way of building up some capital. If you are a Taurus rising, this is in your first house of self. So this is all about you. This is you with a new identity, breaking free, being yourself, truly really coming out as your own identity and forming a new really, current version of yourself and who you are. If you're a Gemini rising, it is in your 12th house of mental health and spirituality. You are probably starting something to support your mental health and well-being internally and privately. If you are a Cancer rising, it's in your 11th house of networking and friends. You're probably starting something like joining or becoming a member of a social group that is really positive. If you are a Leo rising, this is in your 10th house of career. So you are probably starting something new with a job or intention to get a job. If you are a Virgo rising, this is in your 9th house of foreign travel or higher education. You are probably either embarking on traveling somewhere really long distance or learning something new and enrolling in some type of school. If you're a Libra rising, this is in your 8th house of finance, investments, and the occult. So most of you are starting something new with money, savings, trading, investing. Some of you could be starting something new around the occult or a death-related thing in your life, such as a burial or a funeral, but that's unlikely. If you are a Scorpio rising, this is in your 7th house of relationships and close partnerships. So you could be starting a more serious relationship, or you could be doing something like signing a contract. If you are a Sagittarius rising, this is in your 6th house of physical health and also coworkers. So you could be starting something new with something that supports your physical health, like diet, exercise, or wellness, or you could be getting a new group of people to work for you. If you are a Capricorn rising, this is in your 5th house of creativity and romance. So you are probably either starting a new creative project, or you are entering a new romantic relationship. If you're an Aquarius rising, this is in your 4th house of home or family. So something is probably starting with moving somewhere new, or your family with something beginning with that. And if you're a Pisces rising, this is in your 3rd house of day-to-day routine, productivity, and writing. So something day-to-day like content, writing, or a task that you need to be doing is probably going to be starting for you. And the tarot card that we have for this new moon is the Tower. That is the weirdest fucking card I could have pulled for this, because this shows jumping off and basically like you need to eject, jump ship. Maybe this is saying that the new thing comes from you literally having like a tower moment of like falling off. I don't like that, but it's kind of showing like, I guess if there's an awesome new beginning, it comes from maybe you're not doing well and then there's a new beginning. I don't like that though. I don't like pulling the Tower for this. That's a lot. But I guess it comes from like off the back of something really insane that happened. So I hope that you enjoyed this. If you are looking forward to this new moon, please do like and subscribe as well if you enjoyed this video. And if you have any plans, do let me know how they are going for you around this new moon, because it does look to be an exciting one. And I'm excited to read what you all are doing. Anyway, see you in the next one. Oh, there is one.